Greetings, fellow faithful. Bluelunacat here, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. So we made it through to the other side of the sanctum thing. I got expedition returned. Go back, please. Thank you. We did hit the save. So we're still trucking along. Yep, this is after Sanctum. Great.
Aizen, you said a human soul can be reborn as a Moloch given the right trigger, right? Is that something that happens frequently?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that. We know that humans are sometimes reborn as Molochim, but not how or why. It's more likely among people with greater resonance, but the process is still a mystery.
Huh. So it's not something that happens, or that can be made to happen easily. Ordinarily, at least.
But Velvet's sister was reborn as Ceres, and her unborn child came back as Lafayette. What are the chances of that?
It might not have been chance. They both died on the Scarlet Night. Their rebirths may have been influenced by the sacrificial ceremony.
Are you saying that Innominat made it happen on purpose?
Call it an educated guess. But I don't think even an Empyrean can control the lives of humans or Molochim at his whim.
If it wasn't chance, it might have been destiny.
Velvet said she ate Ceres, her own sister reborn as a Moloch. How could such a horrible thing be destiny?
Sorry. I didn't mean to make light of a tragedy, but our fates intertwine, the good and the bad, whether we like it or not. That's what makes it destiny, right?
True. But this...
Get a hold of yourself, Eleanor. Velvet and Lafayette are in rougher waters than any of us. They'll be looking to you to light their way.
Yes. I must remain calm and steady.
Okie dokie. Soul bottles. I think this is the boss, if I were to make a guess. I could be very wrong. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if I was wrong. I have no idea.
Look,
at this point.
Over there.
An earth pulse rift. We may be able to get out from there.
Nope. Another
Arthur,
memory.
There's something I'd like to speak to you about. Alone. Two souls possessing powerful resonance and free of malevolence. These must be sacrificed on the Scarlet Night.
Ah, yes. The ceremony to resurrect Innominat. You read my book.
I haven't fully mastered the ancient tongue yet, but I have read your notes. You wrote that if Innominat is resurrected, we can make a world free of demons.
7 years ago, a soul with strong resonance, my own unborn son, was sacrificed for that purpose. Now, Innominat's resurrection is half complete.
Because of that, everyone's resonance has grown stronger, enabling them to see demons.
Yes, that's the truth behind the opening.
So, if one more person is sacrificed...
Innominat's resurrection will be complete, and his power will spur the creation of many new exorcists.
And there is another Scarlet Knight very soon. Arthur, I must ask.
Lafayette?
Can't I be the sacrifice?
Tell me, why do you think that birds fly?
I think that birds fly because they must. Why else would they have wings if not to embrace the sky? I have wings too, weak as they are. That's why I must fly, now! If we miss this Scarlet Night, the next won't be for another 3 years. By then, I won't be alive.
Lafayette, why would you say such a thing?
The 12-year sickness. That's the name of my disease.
So you know.
I'm not afraid of being sick. But I don't want to just be a burden on everyone until I die. I couldn't take it.
Your wings are your will. And they are strong.
Lars. Please. You can't tell Velvet about this.
I promise.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy. Don't talk to me about Will! About wings! Both of you! Together! You! You betrayed me!
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right? Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
Shut up!
He fell further than this back at the shrine. I will have my revenge. Revenge for Lafayette! Lafayette knew so much more pain than I ever will. And still, I couldn't do anything for him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Shut up! It's a lie! A dirty lie! All of it! It's all their lies! And I believed it! Die!
What is this thing?
An amalgamation of multiple demons?
It doesn't matter what it is! I'll devour it until it's dead!
Okay, are we doing damage to this thing? I'm doing nothing but zero. Ow. Darn it. Weak to fire. There we go. Arts. I'm not sure if this is an unwinnable battle or not. It seemed to be doing zero damage, though. Excuse me. I'm wondering if this is in our windows, weird things. Right. There is my other fire dragon. Infernal torrent. Surprise wave. Oh, I'm doing damage now. Okay. I need to heal myself, but I'm burned, so peninsula bottle.
Yes.
There we go. Sent for. shit. Crazy Chimera. Okay, yeah, I think we can kill this thing. I have to wait for it to stop guarding. Because while it's guarding, I can't do anything. That's how I want shit. There we go. Right, I need to turn everybody's arts back on. I forgot I turned that off. Okay, that's under strategy. Okay, I should limit your arts. It's weak to only fire, guys. Nope, that's not what I wanted. That way they'll do more damage. And in case you can. No, I want that one. He's having fun chasing me. Oh crap. I got caught in that one. Okay. fire. That's not good. I don't want to be on fire. Thank you. Another fire? That's the question, because it seems to be immune to one of them. Yeah, soaring dragon. Turn edge, mega thrust. So, okay. Okay, so I don't have much here. Okay, don't use Cerberus Rave there. And some Feral Torrent. Shit, somebody just died. Okay. Get up. Oh, come on. Really? There. Oh shit.
I can't die here.
Well, that was not good. That was not good at all.
Disgraceful.
We're going to use an all divided, aren't we?
Yes.
It does less damage. Do we have?
Internal torque!
I'm burning. No. Nope. Yes. I am not burning. Shit. That hurt.
Yes.
Chimera. Something. Still has 600 some. I have something that's keeping me from being healed. Yeah, we won. Okay. Stupid chimera.
Is the true face of my sister. She hates, resents, devours, and kills. She tramples people, cities, everything, living only by her emotions. What an ugly, tainted soul.
It's not like that!
Nothing you say will matter. She knows. She knows if it's the truth.
He's right. Just think, everything I did was baseless, arrogant. And even so, I still...
You hurt so many innocent people, didn't you?
More than I can count. I devoured and killed so many.
without even knowing Arthur's true aims.
I destroyed people. I destroyed whole towns.
And worse yet, you didn't even show mercy to your own sister's reincarnation.
I hate her.
And despite all of that, I still love you, Velvet. That's why I chose to become a sacrifice. For you, sister. But think, if you try to stop the resurrection, wouldn't my death be all for nothing? To tell you the truth, I was terrified of dying. It was so dark.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You'll accept it then? That everything you've done up until this point, all of it.
Yes, it was all for nothing and for no one. I hurt so many people, all for no reason. I'm a monster.
If you've accepted it, you have to atone for your sins. Once I eat the final two malevolences inside you, I'll fully awaken. Give them to me. Give me your hatred, your despair. If you do, I can cleanse this world of all its pain. I had hoped that you could live in a world without pain and sadness. But you're a monster now. You don't belong there.
Oh, that's even creepier.
Let me go. We have to go.
No!
If you don't, you'll die too for no reason.
No!
A twisted monster like me doesn't deserve to live. Don't you understand?
You're the reincarnation of the first sacrifice. Part of me. Don't worry. I'll devour you too.
Lafayette, tell this self-absorbed idiot what she needs to hear!
Please, let me go.
Will you stop whining? No, I don't understand! You snap at people! You're scary! You tried to eat me! But you're also kind! And you're filled with life! I don't understand a single thing about you! But you gave me a name! When I was a number! You gave me that compass! You taught me what it meant to be alive! That's why I care about you, Velvet! I'll protect you for my own sake!
Fee...
Your despair. How is it gone?
because she needed just a reminder.
A flame burns in my heart too. A flame I cannot quench no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet. I finally understand how you felt. But the only one I can fight for is myself. That's good enough. That's proof that you are truly alive.
Unquenchable flame. Okay. Oh, I'm glad we're out of there.
Miss Mogilu!
Don't. Don't worry. If Velvet could do it, there's no way I can't.
How many times do you plan to destroy and rebuild your own heart, Mogilu?
We're on 107. Who was it, 108? I lost count. Not that I really care.
Pathetic fool. Did I not tell you it would require an iron will as indomitable as the very trees that live and die across millennia? That is the foundation of an ideal world, one free from man's sins.
An ideal world, huh? You, kid. The boy who was your companion, Lafayette. He's alive. Chasing a terrifying demon girl, he has learned the immensity of the seas and weathered the dry wastes of the land. Those people, they're different from us. Despite the pain, the anguish, they embrace the life they've been given. They live, undaunted by the ugliness of the world!
So you're doing this all for them? Is that what this is?
Not even close. They aggravate me to my wit's end. Like stabs in the chest, over and over and over. And that's exactly why. That's why I intend to see how all of this ends. I won't be satisfied until I do.
Words bereft of meaning. You truly are my greatest failure.
Gosh, funny just how little I care.
No! Please!
Oh, there we go.
Let me guess. We came at a good time?
You're late. Because of you, I had to have a really boring conversation.
So, you came face to face with Innominat. If so, then you must know that your quest for revenge is utterly meaningless.
Yeah, I did. I know why sadness fills the world, and I know how deep are the burdens of sin. I tried to abandon my memories of Arthur and Laffy, to cut myself off from it all, and end this tragedy. It's what they would have wanted.
Exactly. You do well to know your place.
But that's exactly why I can't forgive them. Not Artorias, not Enominat. I know my heart is ugly and full of contradictions, but those days we spent together in familial warmth, they're proof that I, that all of us, were truly alive. That's why, no matter how hard, no matter how sad it gets, I will take my vengeance to the very end!
Velvet!
Don't be a fool! Just give up and die like you ought! It is your destiny to wallow in despair!
You take my family, turn me into a monster, and you want my soul too? Now who's being the fool? Remember this well. The Lord of Calamity never gives up, not even in the face of death.
Have you no shame for your sins, you unholy monster?
You're just annoying.
Let me in on this. I lost a bet, and I've got some anger to work out.
You sure you can fight in your condition?
Who do you think I am? Ooh, I thought you'd never ask. I am the dastardly witch Mogilu, scourge of self-righteous exorcists! Now face the wrath of Mogilu Maven!
Fools, all of you!
And you're in their boss fight.
Sorry to have worried you.
I wasn't worried.
Okay, he's weak to wind, and little ones. Weak to hand arms. Huh. 17001. Something tells me we need to get rid of the little one first. I didn't. Okay. I don't know. I have pretty close to the same amount of health. Whoops. That's alright. Pay attention, Bridgie. Okay. And like Cyclone. Raising Falcon. Counting Strike.
Realize you were someone who needed looking after.
Me neither.
This is our way of saying we trust you.
Yeah!
You horrible imprint! See? Stabbed in the chest, that's all you give me!
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah, we need to do something about that little one. He has a tendency to turn enemies against each other. Or friends against each other, I mean.
Resonate!
Yes, I did. Let's just turn everything back on. And he's weak to wind. Change my abilities. Solo dance. Moonlight Tycoon. Rising Falcon. That looks like fun. Okay, Rising Falcon doesn't always hit, so what can I use instead of that? Got Vanishing Thunder. Silver Wave? Ow. No! Shit. Come on. Ah, crap.
No, nothing will stop.
We'll try.
Fine, fine. I'll join your little combat crew.
Okay, so I have to switch this back over. Okay, after Gordon spin. Okay, after Harsh Retribution. There we go. I think. Yeah, right in. No, keep that on. Okay, so after I take out the little one, I think he's in all divided. So he doesn't one KO us and with one single attack. I have to take out little one first. Okay. retry.
Fools, all of you!
Everyone, sorry to have worried you.
I wasn't worried.
I didn't realize you were someone who needed looking at.
Me neither.
This is all right now. Rise! Arise! Ascending! Angel!
Whoops. Okay, I need to do something about the peninsula. Oh, there we go. No, you're not allowed to do any spells. There we go. Okay. Number one. An old divide. Yes. Number two. Change my arts to... What is he weak to? Win. Change all my arts to win. Solo dance. Rising Falcon pits me over him. Bounding Strike. Okay. Shadow Flow and Ashing Thunder. Okay, should limit everyone else to just wind. Attacks that have wind added to them. There we go. You don't have a lot of wind attacks, do you, sweetie? Okay. Oh, yikes. Let me bring you up! course, that also means he's going to damage him as quickly either. But he has that one nasty spell. Reason I'm only doing a little attack and then guard is I want to make sure I can air up this spell. There we go. He's almost dead. Oh, jeez. Did we win? Did we win? I didn't see the end screen for our battle.
Tell Artorias and Enomi not. They took something precious from me. I'll never forgive them for that.
The annals of history are stained with evil people like you. You spread havoc and destruction, all to satisfy your own ends. A dark font of malevolence. You're a demon lord, the irredeemable embodiment of sin.
The Lord of Calamity.
It is the Exorcist's duty to destroy you!
You talk a lot. How about you keep talking and tell us where Ifrit is?
You'll regret this.
I can feel Enominat! He's coming!
We can fight here no longer!
Bianfu, close the rift! I can't!
Come forth!
Oh.
Carelessness will get you killed.
Zavid!
You ruined the moment.
Huh? Don't you mean, thanks for saving us, Zavid? You're my hero and role model.
Hello, Mr. Cheeky.
Thank you for saving us, Zavid.
Where exactly are we now?
We're in an abbey facility on Hexen Isle. I heard Melchior was in charge here, so I snuck in. I hadn't expected an extra-dimensional space.
Is there a way out?
There is now that I busted my way in.
Let's head outside. We can talk then.
Oh.
Who's that?
A friend. His name is Number One.
Hey, wanna come with us? If you stay here alone, a dragon might get you. I bet you wouldn't like that.
Yeah, that sounds scary.
Great. Come on, kid.
What are you doing?
You can't leave him like this. I'll get him a vessel, somehow.
Do what you like.
There we go. That's what I was looking for. End screen. And a save point. So, with that, I'm going to leave this episode here. If you enjoyed it, be sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. And if you can, support me on Patreon. I'll see you next video. Bye!